The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Loving and righteous God, we come together at this Easter Vigil service to celebrate your resurrection from the dead. To remember that you are the light of the world. And with you in our lives, O God, we can be assured that all the darkness will be dispelled through your resurrection. You have brought hope to our lives. Even as we celebrate you at this our Easter Vigil, may we be mindful that your resurrection reminds us that you have overcome the sting of death and the sting of sin. And so we are now able to bask in the freedom that you have brought to the entire world. Through Jesus' holy name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Dear friends in Christ, on this most holy night, when our Lord Jesus Christ passed from death to life, the Church invites our children throughout the world to come together in vigil and prayer. This is the Passover of the Lord. We remember his death and the resurrection by hearing his word and celebrating his mysteries. We are confident that we shall share his victory over death and live with him forever in God. Let us pray. Father, we share in the light of your glory through your Son, the light of the world. Sanctify this new fire and inflame us with new hope. Purify our minds by this Easter celebration, and bring us one day to the feast of eternal life. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Page 254 for the preparation of the candle. Christ, yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and Omega, all times belongs to him, and all the ages to him be glory and power to every age, forever and ever.
Amen.
By his holy and glorious wounds, may Christ, our Lord, guard us and keep us. Amen.
Amen.
May the light of Christ rising in glory dispel the darkness of our hearts and minds. the light of Christ.
Thanks be to God. The light of Christ.
Light the others behind you as well, please. Remember to stop and light the others behind you as well. For the others. Let us stand. Page 256.
Rejoice, heavenly powers, sing cries of angels, exalt all creation around God's throne. Jesus Christ, our King, is risen. Sound the trumpet of salvation. Rejoice, O earth, in shining splendor, radiant in the brightness of your King. Christ has conquered, glory fills you, darkness vanishes forever. Rejoice, O Mother Church, exalt in glory, the risen Savior shines upon you. Let this place resound with joy, echoing the mighty song of all God's people.
The Lord be with you.
And also be with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is indeed right that with full hearts and minds and voices we should praise you, the unseen God, the Father Almighty, and your only Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who has ransomed us by his death and paid for us the price of Adam's sin. For this is the Passover of the true Lamb of God, by whose blood the homes of all the faithful are hallowed and protected. This is the night when of old you saved our fathers, delivering the people of Israel, leading them dry shod through the sea. This is the night when Jesus Christ vanquished hell and rose triumphant from the grave. This is the night when all who believe in him are free from sin and restored to grace and holiness. Most blessed of all nights, when heaven is wedded to earth and all creation reconciled to God. Dear for Heavenly Father, in the joy of this night, accept our sacrifice of praise, your church's solemn offering, and grant that this Easter candle may make our darkness light. For Christ, the morning star, has risen, never again to set, and is alive and raised forever and ever.
Amen.
You may sit. Dear friends in Christ, let us now listen attentively to the word of God, recording how he saved his people throughout history, and in the fullness of time, sent his own Son to be our Redeemer.
Reading from the book of Genesis, chapter 1, reading from verse 1 to chapter 2, verse 4. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw that the light was good. And God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, let there be a dome in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters. So God made the dome, and separated the waters that were under the dome from the waters that were above the dome. And it was so. God called the dome sky, and there was evening, and there was morning, the second day. And God said, let the waters under the sky be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear. And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called the sea. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let the earth put forth vegetation, plants yielding seeds, and fruit trees of every kind on earth that bear fruit with the seed in it. And it was so. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed of every kind, and trees of every kind bearing fruit with the seed in it. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the third day. And God said, let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night. And let them be for signs, and for seasons, and for days and years. And let them be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth. And it was so. God made two greater lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night, and the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from darkness. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fourth day. And God said, let the waters bring forth swarms of living creatures, and let the birds fly above the earth across the dome of the sky. So God created the great sea monsters and every living creature that moves, of every kind, with which the waters swarm, and every winged bird of every kind. And God saw that it was good. God blessed them, saying, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the waters of the seas, and let the birds multiply in the earth. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fifth day. And God said, let the earth bring forth living creatures of every kind, cattle and creeping things, and wild animals of every kind. And it was so. God made the wild animals of the earth of every kind, and the cattle of every kind, and everything that creeps upon the ground of every kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth. So God created humankind in his image. In the image of God, he created them, male and female. And he blessed them. And God said to them, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves upon the earth. God said, see, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit, you shall have for them food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has breath of life, I have given you every green plant for food. And it was so. God saw everything that he had made, and indeed it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. Thus the heaven and the earth were finished, and all their multitude. And on the seventh day, God finished the work he had done. And he rested on the seventh day from all the work he had done. So God blessed the seventh day and hallowed it, because on it God rested from all the work that he had done in creation. These are the generations of the heavens and the earth when they were created. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm appointed is Psalm 33, found on page 506. Rejoice in the Lord, your righteous. Praise the Lord with a harp.
Play to him upon the psalm and on the
harp. Sing for him a new song.
Song that hath fear with all your skill upon the trumpet.
For the word of the Lord is right.
And all his works are sure.
He loves righteousness and justice.
The loving kindness of the Lord fills the whole earth.
By the word of the Lord were the heavens made.
By the breath of his mouth, all heaven moves.
He gathers up the waters of the ocean as in a water skin.
And stores up the depths of the sea.
Let all the earth fear the Lord.
Let all who dwell in the world stand in awe.
For he spoke and it came to pass.
He commanded and it was to pass.
The Lord brings the will of the nations to naught.
He pours the design of the peoples.
But the Lord's will stands fast forever.
And the designs of his heart from age to age.
Happy is the nation whose God is the Lord.
Happy is the people who have chosen to be.
The Lord looks down from heaven
and beholds all the people of the world.
From where he sits enthroned, he turns his gaze
on all who dwell on the earth.
He fashions all the hearts of them
and understands all their works.
There is no king that can be saved by a mighty army.
A strong man is not delivered by his great strength.
The heart is a vain hope for deliverance.
For all his friends he cannot save.
Behold, the eye of the Lord is upon those who fear him.
On those who wait upon his law.
To pluck their lives from death.
And to keep them in time of famine.
Our soul waits for the Lord.
He is our heaven and our shield.
Indeed, our heart rejoices in him.
For in his holy name we put our trust.
Let your loving kindness, O Lord, be upon us.
As we have put our trust in you.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son,
and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, you created all things with wonderful beauty and order. Help us now to perceive how still more wonderful is the new creation, by which in the fullness of time you redeem your people through the sacrifice of all Passover, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Thank you.
A reading from the Word of God as written in the book of Genesis, chapter 7, beginning at verse 1. The Lord said to Noah, "Go into the ark, you and all your household, for I have seen that you alone are righteous before me in this generation. Take with you 7 pairs of all clean animals, the male and its mate, and a pair of the animals that are not clean, the male and its mate, and 7 pairs of the birds of the air also, male and female, to keep their kind alive on the earth, on the face of all the earth. For in 7 days I will send rain on the earth for 40 days and 40 nights, and every living thing that I have made I will blot out from the face of the ground." And Noah did all that the Lord had commanded him. In the 600th year of Noah's life, in the 2nd month, on the 17th day of the month, on that day, all the fountains of the great deep burst forth, and the windows of the heavens were opened. The rain fell on the earth 40 days and 40 nights. On the very same day, Noah, with his son Shem and Ham and Japheth, and Noah's wife, and the 3 wives of his 3 sons, entered the ark, they and every wild animal of every kind, and all domestic animals of every kind, and every creeping thing that creeps on the earth, and every bird of every kind, every bird, every winged creature. They went into the ark with Noah, 2 and 2 of all the flesh in which there was the breath of life. And those that entered, male and female of all flesh, went in as God had commanded him, and the Lord shut him in. The flood continued 40 days on the earth, and the waters increased, and more of the ark, and it rose high above the earth. The water swelled and increased greatly on the earth, and the ark floated on the face of the waters. At the end of 40 days, Noah opened the window of the ark that he had made, and sent out the raven. And it went to and fro until the waters were dried up from the earth. Then he sent out the dove from him, to see if the waters had subsided from the face of the ground. But the dove found no place to rest its foot, and it returned to him on the ark, for the waters were still on the face of the whole earth. So he put out his hand and took it in and brought it into the ark with him. He waited another 7 days, and again he sent out the dove from the ark, and the dove came back to him in the evening, and there in its beak was a freshly plucked olive leaf. So Noah knew that the water had subsided from the earth. Then he waited another 7 days, and sent out the dove, and it did not return to him anymore. In the 601st year, in the 1st month, the 1st day of the month, the waters were dried up from the earth, and Noah removed the covering of the ark and looked, and saw that the face of the ground was drying. In the 2nd month, on the 27th day of the month, the earth was dried. Then God said to Noah, "Go out of the ark, you and your wife, and your sons, and your wives, your sons' wives with you. Bring out with you every living thing that is with you of all flesh, bird and animal, and every creeping thing that creeps on the earth, so that they may abound on the earth, and be fruitful and multiply on the earth." So Noah went out with his sons, and his wife, and his sons' wives. Then God said to Noah, and to his sons with him, "As for me, I am establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that is with you, the birds, the domestic animals, and every animal of the earth with you, as many as seem out of the earth. I establish my covenant with you, that never again shall all flesh be cut off by the waters of a flood, and never again shall there be a flood to destroy the earth. God said, this is the sign of the covenant that I make between me and you, and every living creature that is with you, for all future generations. I have set my bow in the clouds, and it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will read Psalm 46, found on page 527. God is our refuge and strength,
a very present help in trouble.
Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth be moved,
and although our mountains are troubled on the depths of seas,
though its waters rage and foam,
and though the mountains tremble at its summit,
the Lord of hosts is with us.
The God of Jacob is our stronghold.
There is a river whose streams may glad the city of God,
the holy habitation of the Most High.
God is in the midst of her. She shall not be overthrown.
God shall help her at the breaking of day.
The nations make much ado, and the kingdoms are shaken.
God has spoken, and the earth shall melt away.
The Lord of hosts is with us.
The God of Jacob is our stronghold.
Come now and look upon the works of the Lord.
What awesome things he has done on earth.
It is he who makes war to cease in all the world.
He breaks the bow and shatters the spear and burns the shields with fire.
Be still then and know that I am God.
I will be exalted upon the nations. I will be exalted in the earth.
The Lord of hosts is with us.
The God of Jacob is our stronghold.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever.
Let us pray. Faithful God, you have placed a rainbow in the skies as a sign of your covenant with all living things. May we who are saved through water and the Spirit worthily offer to you our sacrifice of thanksgiving. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Book of Exodus,
are still doing here, the Israelites look back, and they were the Egyptians advancing on them. In great fear, the Israelites cried out to the Lord. They said to Moses, was it because there were no graves in Egypt that you were taken up away to die in the wilderness? What have you done to us? Bring us out of Egypt? Is this not the very thing we told you in Egypt? Let us alone and let us serve the Egyptians. For it would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians than to die in the wilderness. But Moses said to the people, do not be afraid. Stand firm and see the deliverance that the Lord will accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you shall never see again. The Lord will fight for you, and you have only to keep still. Then the Lord said to Moses, why do you cry out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward. But you lift up your staff and stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, that the Israelites may go into the sea on dry ground. Then I will harden the heart of the Egyptians, so that they will go in after them. And so I will gain glory for myself over Pharaoh and all his army, his chariot and his chariot drivers. And the Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord, when I have gained glory for myself over Pharaoh, his chariot, and his chariot drivers. The angel of God, who was going before the Israelites, are moved and went behind them, and the pillar of cloud moved from in front of them and took its place behind them. It came between the army of Egypt and the army of Israel. And so the cloud was there with the darkness, and in the midst of the night, one did not come near the other all night. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. The Lord drove the sea back by a great east wind all night, and turned the sea into dry land, and the waters were divided. The Israelites went into the sea on dry ground, the waters forming a wall for them on their right and on their left. The Egyptians pursued and went into the sea after them. All of Pharaoh's horses, chariots, and chariot drivers. At the morning, watch the Lord in the pillar of fire and cloud. Look down upon the Egyptian army, and put the Egyptian army into panic. He caused their chariot wheels so that they turned into difficulty. The Egyptian said, let us flee from the Israelites, for the Lord is fighting for them against Egypt. Then the Lord said to Moses, stretch out your hand over the sea, so that the water may come back to the Egyptians from their chariots and their chariot drivers. So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn the sea returned to its normal depth. As the Egyptians fled before it, the Lord tossed the Egyptians back into the sea. The water turned and covered the chariots and the chariot drivers. The entire army of Pharaoh that had followed them into the sea, not one of them remained. But the Israelites walked on dry ground through the sea, the waters forming a wall for them on their right and on their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel that day from the Egyptians, and Israel saw the Egyptians dead on the seashore. Israel saw the great work that the Lord did against the Egyptians. So the people feared the Lord and believed in the Lord and in his servant Moses. Then the prophet Miriam, Aaron's sister, took a tambourine in her hand, and all the women went out after her with tambourines and with dancing. And Miriam sang to them, sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. Hearts and riders he has thrown into the sea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
page 49. I will sing to the Lord for his glorious triumph. The horse and the rider he has hurled me to sea. The Lord has become my strength and refuge. The Lord himself has become my savior. He is my God, and I will praise him. My father's God, and I will exalt him. The Lord himself is a mighty warrior. The Lord is his name. Your right hand, O Lord, is majestic in power. Your right hand, O Lord, shatters the enemy. Who is like you, O Lord, among the gods? Holy, awesome, ruler of the universe. In steadfast love, you led your people. You guided your redeemed with your great strength. You brought them in safety to your holy place and planted them firm on your own mountain. You brought them into your own house. The Lord shall reign forever and ever.
God of steadfast love, your wonderful deeds of old shine forth even to our own day. By the power of your mighty arm, you once delivered your chosen people from slavery and your favor to be a sign for us of the salvation of all nations by the water of baptism. Grant that all the people of the earth may be numbered among the offspring of Abraham, and rejoice in the inheritance of Israel. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Baruch, chapter 3. Reading from verse 9. Hear the commandments of life, O Israel. Give ear and learn wisdom. Why is it, O Israel, why is it that you are in the land of your enemies, that you are growing old in a foreign country, that you are defiled into the dead, that you are counted among those in hate? You have forsaken the fountain of wisdom. If you had walked in the way of God, you would be living in peace forever. Learn where there is wisdom, where there is strength, where there is understanding, so that you may at the same time discern where there is length of days and life, where there is light for the eyes and peace. Who has found her place? And who has entered her storehouses? But the one who knows all things knows her. He found her by his understanding. The one who prepared the earth for all time, filled it with four-footed creatures. The one who sends forth the light and it goes, he called it, and it obeyed him. Trembling the stars shone in their watches and were glad. He called them, and they said, here we are. They shunned with gladness for him who made them. This is our God. No other can be compared to him. He found the whole way to knowledge, and gave her to his servant Jacob, and to Israel, whom he loved. Afterward, she appeared on earth and lived with humankind. She is the book of the commandments of God, the law that endures forever. All who hold her fast will live, and those who forsake her will die. Turn, O Jacob, and take her. Walk toward the shining of her light. Do not give your glory to another, or your advantages to an alien people. Happy we are, O Israel, for we know what is pleasing to God, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 19, found on page 490. The heavens declare the glory of God,
and the firmament shows his handiwork.
One day tells its tale to another,
and one man imparts knowledge to another.
Although they have no words or language,
and their voices are not heard,
their song has gone out in all lands,
and their message to the ends of the world.
In the deep has he set a pavilion for the sun.
It comes forth like a bridegroom out of his chamber. It rejoices like a champion to run its course.
It goes forth from the utmost edge of the heavens and runs above to the end of it again.
Nothing is hidden from its burning heat.
The law of the Lord is perfect and revives the soul.
The testimony of the Lord is sure, and he gives love to the innocent.
The statutes of the Lord are just and rejoice the heart.
The commandment of the Lord is clear, and gives light to the eyes.
The fear of the Lord is clean and endures forever.
The judgment of the Lord are true and righteous altogether.
More to be desired are they than gold, more than much fine gold.
Sweeter are than honey, than honey in the cold.
By them also is your servant enlightened,
and in keeping them there is great reward.
Who can tell how often he offends?
Cleanse me from my secret thoughts.
Above all, keep your servant from presumptuous sins.
Let them not
get dominion over me.
Then shall I be bold and strong, and innocent of a great offense.
Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight.
O Lord, my strength and my Redeemer.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Living God, by the Passover of your Son, you have brought us out of sin into righteousness, and out of death into life. Grant to those who are seen by your Holy Spirit the will and power to proclaim you to all the world in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. The reading from the Word of God, as written in Vigil, beginning in Vigil chapter 36, beginning at verse 24. I will take you from the nations and gather you from all the countries and bring you into your own land. I will sprinkle clean water upon you, and you shall be clean from all your uncleanness. cleanse you. A new heart I will give you, and a new spirit I will put within you, and I will remove from your body the heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. I will put my spirit within you and make you follow my statutes and be careful to observe my ordinances. Then you shall live in the land that I gave to your ancestors, and you shall be my people, and I will be your God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Found on page 521. As the deer longs for the water brooks,
so longs my soul for you, O God.
My soul is a thirst for God, a thirst for the living God.
When shall I come to appear before the presence of God?
My tears have been my food day and night.
While all day long they say to me, where now is your God?
I pour out my soul when I think on these things.
Come and rend the multitude and let them into the house of God.
With the voice of praise and thanksgiving,
among those who keep holy day.
Why are you so full of heaviness, O my soul?
And why are you so disquieted within me?
Put your trust in God.
For I will yet give thanks to him, who is the help of my countenance and my God.
My soul is heavy within me.
Therefore I will remember you from the land of Jordan and from the deep of Midgar, among the heights of Hermon.
One be calls to another in the noise of your cataracts.
All your rapids and floods have gone over me.
The Lord grants his loving kindness in the daytime.
In the night season his song is with me, a prayer to the God of my life.
I will say to the God of my strength, why have you forgotten me?
And why do I so tenderly about the ending of the Christmas?
Why my bones are being broken,
my enemies mock me to my eyes.
All day long they mock me
and say to me, where now is your God?
Why are you so full of heaviness, O my soul?
And why are you so disquieted within me?
Put your trust in God.
For I will yet give thanks to him, who is the help and my countenance and my God. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, in the Paschal mystery, you established the new covenant of reconciliation. Grant that all who are born again in baptism may so practice their lives what they profess by their faith. Grant this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
We stand as we sing the glory with the hymn number 547. 5 4 7.
Mm-hmm. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
cup of life and light. This holy night shines with the radiance of the risen Christ. Renew your church with the Spirit given to us in baptism, that we may worship you in sincerity and truth, and shine as a light in the world through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Reading from the Word of God as written in the letter of Paul to the Romans, chapter 6, beginning at verse 3. Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, so we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with Christ in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body of sin might be destroyed, and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 140, found on page 621. Hallelujah! When Israel came out of Egypt,
the house of Jacob from a people of strange speech,
Judah became God's sanctuary,
and Israel his dominion.
The sea beheld it and fled.
Jordan turned and went back.
The mountains kicked like rams,
and the little hills like young sheep.
What aided you, O sea, that you fled?
O Jordan, that you turned back.
You mountains that you skipped like rams,
you little hills like young sheep.
Tremble, O earth, at the presence of the Lord.
At the presence of the God of Jacob,
who turned the hard rock into a pool of water,
and his soul into a flowing spring.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever.
taking the spices they had prepared. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb. But when they went in, they did not find the body. While they were perplexed about this, suddenly two men in dazzling clothes stood beside them. The women were terrified and bowed their faces to the ground. But the men said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here, but has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still in Galilee that the Son of Man must be handed over to sinners and be crucified? And on the third day, rise again." Then they remembered his words. And returning from the tomb, they told all this to the 11 and to all the rest. Now it was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary the mother of James, and the other women with them who told this to the apostles. But these words seemed to them an idle tale, and they did not believe them. But Peter got up and ran to the tomb. Stooping and looking in, he saw the linen cloths by themselves. Then he went home, amazed at what had happened. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise Christ, O Lord. It is that darkness we fear, as we will never be able to deal with the absence of that loved one. This darkness drives us to have that overwhelming desire to bury that person in dignity, giving him what we call a good funeral. For Christians, when a person dies, it is a moment to gather together at worship, to give thanks for the life that has now been completed, to comfort one another with the promises of the gospel, to proclaim to the world that death is never an end in itself, and we should never allow it to prevent us from worshiping our Savior. The Gospel tells us that after the crucifixion, John chapter 19, Joseph and Nicodemus took the body of Jesus to prepare it for funeral. Their preparation of the body was in anticipation of the resurrection. We know that the tomb in which they placed Jesus' body was not his final resting place, as within 3 days he would again be alive. this, my friends, reassures us that death is not so final as it, that it should stop us from looking ahead. It is not different when we lay Christians to rest today. When we lay our brothers and sisters to rest, we are burying them not just that they can be buried, but we do so in anticipation of their resurrection from the dead on the day when the Savior returns. The grave, my friend, is not the end of us any more than it was the end of our Lord. This is the day. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Psalm 180, verse 24. For all we have, for all of them, we have not sung the Hallelujah. But now we can sing glory to God in the highest, because Jesus has conquered and the enemy of death has taken victory over sin and death. Among us are those who may say, what does rising from the dead mean? It means, my friend, that death no longer has the final power. It is the event of our life after death in which despair gives way to hope, darkness changed to light, hatred changed to love, and sorrow to joy. We should be glad because Jesus' rising from the dead has liberated us from fear. That fear of what happens after death. Brothers and sisters, the hope for new life here and now can only be experienced if we only believe. Many of us have suffered a lot, either of a loved one or being disabled by an illness. For some, they die bit by bit. But friends, if we believe in the presence of the risen Jesus in our lives, we will discover new dreams to pursue, new challenges to face, and new reasons to try. God made Jesus to rise from the dead, and this risen Lord will raise us from any power or force of the devil that threaten our lives or may try to dominate us. The story of the suffering and death of Jesus on Good Friday is the story of triumph over injustice and evil power. Jesus was falsely charged of crime he did not commit. He was unjustly sentenced to a death he did not deserve. His friends betrayed him. His trusted companions deserted him. And his number one denied him. The people he loved demanded his crucifixion and chose to have the bandit Barnabas released in his place. Can we see it as a story of betrayal and lies, dishonesty and meanness, unfaithfulness and wicked violence directed against an innocent, helpless victim? Can we imagine ourselves being fought up against these accusations? Have we wondered about it and thought about how we would have reacted? My friend, all this comes to an end on Good Friday when we see Jesus first mocked, led to the death mask, nailed to the cross where he died after 2 hours, and was taken to be buried in a tomb. If that were the end of the story, that would be a bad story. Yes, my friend, it would have been a tragedy. But we need to give God the glory that he did not. All that Jesus endured for our good. And now, Jesus rises from the dead in all glory and majesty. Jesus reigns eternal glory with the Father. Jesus regains eternal glory with the Father. And Jesus will prevail over all mankind. There is a song that tells the story of the resurrection, of the crucifixion. And I will just sing the chorus for you. Today in our society, there are unbelievers who do not want to hear the truth that Jesus is risen. They do not want to hear that Jesus speaks to us every day in the scriptures and in the church. I say to you this afternoon, do not give up on the truth, even when everybody seems to give up on it. Do not give up on justice. Do not give up on doing what is right. The fact is, truth will always be the truth. Just will always be just. Right will always be right. even when the birds around us will have it otherwise. We must learn to believe in the sun, even when it is not shining, knowing that by and by, it will shine again. It is the end of the story that comes. That is why we are asked to rejoice and be glad, because Jesus Christ has risen. Even when we are going through difficult times, through the betrayal, unjust discrimination, lies, even when the devil seems to be winning the battle in our lives, my Christian brothers, let us remember that Christ has done it. Christ has won. And we know that in Christ, we will overcome. With Christ's resurrection, let our faith be reassured that God who raised Jesus from the dead will also raise us up to overcome all adversities. Amen.
Amen.
In preparation for the renewal of our baptismal vows, I invite us to turn to hymn number 630, 631.
Thank you.
463. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
We thank you for the gift of water. Oh, water, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through water, we led the children of Israel out of the abundance in Egypt into the promised land. In water, your son Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us to his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it you were buried with Christ in his death, by which we share in his resurrection, through which we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we celebrate our fellowship in him in faith. We pray that all who pass through the water of baptism may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ, our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, your honor and glory now and forever.
Amen.
Dear friends, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may rise with him to new life. Now that our Lenten observance is ended, let us renew the promises we made in baptism, when we rejected Satan and all his works, and promised to serve God faithfully in his holy Catholic Church. Do you declare and promise that you will, with the help of God, live your life in faith of Christ, into which you were baptized?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, the Holy Son of our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
I believe. Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread, and in the prayers?
Amen.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and repent whenever you fall into sin?
Amen.
Will you be a witness in your daily life to God's saving work in Christ?
Amen.
Will you seek and serve Christ by loving your neighbor as yourself, remembering that every person is loved and valued by God?
Amen.
Do you put your whole trust in his grace and love?
I do. And in God's service, I will follow Christ as my Savior and Lord.
We will now be sprinkled with holy water in order to remind us of our baptismal communion. During the singing,
during the singing of Wonderful Grace, I will come along to sprinkle you with holy water. The hymn is a sprinkling on him.
Thank you.
the name of the upper tree, 177.
Thank you. Give it to them. Where 1997, I come with God.
The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the eternal covenant, made you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well pleasing in his sight, and the blessing of God Almighty the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Let me extend a special welcome to you all. Special welcome to the churches that have joined us across the pure. And I would like to also extend a special welcome to those who have joined us online. As we journey home, I wish for you God's richest blessings. And please remember to be safe. The reception is 267. 4 in number 4 words.